Good morning, today. Today we are going to talk about agriculture. India is primarily agriculture based country. Mahatma Gandhi rightly said, Indian agriculture is the backbone of the Indian economy. Because these are the four reasons. 58% of the people of the Indian population simply depending upon agriculture production. Roughly about 1027 million people getting employed and 30 crores of animals are being fed with. Agriculture is not a purely an English word. So it is derived from the Latin language. Agri means land. Culture means cultivation, which means it's a land cultivation. It contributes 14.5% to the national income. What do you mean by this national income? The goods and services produced within the geographical frontier of a particular country. So 14%, more than that, it contributes to the national income. It also contributes raw materials to the agro-based industries. What do you mean by this agro-based industries? The raw materials are being got from the agricultural production. For example, cotton industries, sugar industries, all these are all agro-based industries. What are the factors that are favorable for the Indian cultivation of this agriculture? The vast area, we have vast area for the cultivation, and the suitable climate, the tropical climate, the soil, variety of soils that we have, and the labor force, that is the main factor. As I will tell you, roughly about 58% of the Indian population are being employed. So cheap labor is available in India. Rice and wheat are simply called the staple food in India. Staple food in the sense, these two products are being used very much for our living. What are the progress made? In 1969, the effort, pure effort of M.S. Swaminathan introduced green revolution in India. This green revolution has given a boost to the cultivators, the farmers. He has introduced a lot of high-yield variety of seeds. For example, IR20, Jaya, Malika. So these are some of the varieties, rice pony, then white pony. So these are the varieties of seeds being introduced by the eminent scholar in order to increase the production in the agricultural field. Then in the food, how it has been increased. In 1940-50, the calculation says only 149.2 lakh tons of rice are being produced. But in the calculation says 1913-14, it has tremendously increased to 265 million tons. So it's a drastic improvement in the field of agriculture. production. The industries, especially the cotton and the sugarcane industries, fivefold increase match the situation. The exports, tea, coffee, cashew, all these plantation crops simply increased their own production. Employment, as usual, I told you, 58% people of the Indian population are simply getting employed in this agricultural field. What are the types available? A shifting, which means it has some names, zooming we call it, or slash and burn we call it. What do you mean by that? A part of the land is being burned after the harvested. It will not be cultivated till the soil gets its own fertility again. Till then, it will not be used for anything. Especially the trees are being cut and slashed. That's why it is called slash and burn cultivation. Then what is the settled cultivation? It has two types. Subsistence and commercial. Subsistence in the sense, the production is used only to maintain a particular family, that's all, for nothing else. Cultivate, eat, finish. Commercial, it is used for trade, mainly for trade, but also it is used for some asset for our own subsistence level. The commercial has four types: intensive type of cultivation, and the extensive type of cultivation, and plantation cultivation, and mixed farming. Intensive in the sense, a part of land or the part of available land is intensively cultivated. In a year, roughly about 3 or 4 times they cultivate and use that land only for cultivation and for subsistence land. Intensively the land is kept cultivated. Extensive, where the land is more, the area is more, where we can cultivate a part of land for rice, part of land for wheat, part of land for sugar cane, something like that. The crop will be more, but it is extensive. Extensively being cultivated. A plantation crops, rubber, especially rubber, coffee, tea. They are used for consumption as well as for trade. Then mixed farming, which means most of the lands are being used for dual crop or triangle crops. As the summary, if you see agriculture, when I say agriculture, it includes the allied activities. Allied activities in the sense, forestry, fishery, animal husbandry, and poultry. So when we say agriculture, a single term will include all these four also. So agriculture is primarily very much depending on the national income. How the national income simply depends upon agriculture. If you have any doubt, you can proceed with this and go through the pages that I am going to give you. Go through the pages 178 and 179. Just 2 pages you can go through, and 180 also you can go through. So these are the 3 pages that I recommend to you go through and get notes of that. This is the assignment. Just go through that. Thank you. Have a nice day.